Decimal numbers, which we use in everyday life, are also called base 10. Hexadecimal, on the other hand, is base 16. The base indicates how many numerals the number system uses. Decimal has 10, 0 through 9, and hexadecimal has 16, 0 through 9, followed by A through F, which means A represents 10, B represents 11, C represents 12, and so on, all the way up to F, which is 15. Next, as you know, decimal has places like the ones place, tens place, hundreds place, and so on. These grow in powers of 10 because we have 10 numerals. Well, hexadecimal has the 16s place, 256's place, 4096's place, 65536's place, and so on. These are powers of 16 because we have 16 numerals. Not only do these look a lot more complicated, but they also grow significantly with each added digit. Don't let that scare you, it's just another number system. Let's take a hexadecimal number and convert it into decimal. Here I wrote the places as exponents, just because it makes everything a lot easier to look at. First, we multiply each place with its numeral. This gives us a value for each digit. We then add them all together, and that's our number in decimal. The opposite works as well. Similar to binary, where we repeatedly divide a decimal number by 2, here we do the same, but with 16. Divide 572 by 16, and we get 35.75. However, we want to find the remainder of this division. To do this, we take the fractional part of the result and multiply it by 16. Here, that gives us a remainder of 12. Then we take 35 and repeat the same steps. This time we end up with 2 and a remainder of 3. And finally, taking 2 and repeating the process, we get 0 with a remainder of 2. Now we just take the remainders and arrange them from the bottom up. Of course, these digits are currently in decimal, which means we have to convert them to hexadecimal. 2 is 2 in hexadecimal, 3 is 3, but 12 is C. And that's it. 572 is 23C in hexadecimal. To convert hexadecimal into binary, we simply convert each digit into a group of 4 binary digits. First, we convert a hexadecimal digit into decimal, which is really simple. Here, 9 stays a 9, and D is the hexadecimal numeral for 13. Then we convert each of these into binary. For 9, we set the 8's place to 1 and the 1's place to 1. And for 13, we sent the 8's, 4's, and 1's place to 1. Now we just put the two portions of our number back together, and that's it. The reason this works is because one digit in hexadecimal and 4 digits in binary can both represent exactly 16 unique values. Therefore, we can just separate each hexadecimal digit, or 4 bits, and treat them as completely unrelated chunks of a number. As always, the same works in reverse. To convert binary to hexadecimal, we once again separate the binary number into chunks of 4 digits. Each chunk is then converted into decimal. And then we convert each decimal number to its hexadecimal counterpart. 14 is an E, 10 is an A, and 5 and 9 stay the same. Of course, you could easily skip the intermediate step and convert straight to hexadecimal, but I find it a little easier to follow this way. Now, why do we need hexadecimal at all? Say we have a large binary number like this. We can write the same number in decimal, and of course also in hexadecimal. At first glance, hexadecimal has one advantage: it's more compact. But you might say that decimal is also pretty compact and it looks much more familiar to us, so why don't we just use decimal? Well, let's actually store something useful in our binary number, like a color. Our color is going to be represented as an ARGB value, which means we have an alpha component, or opacity, followed by a red, green, and blue component. And each of these components is going to use 8 bits. In our 32-bit number, that would look like this. Now if you look at the decimal number, how much red is in it? You can't tell. That is because there's no nice alignment between binary and decimal numbers. But in hexadecimal, if you remember, each digit represents 4 binary digits. That means every pair of 2 digits represents 8 binary digits. In other words, because hexadecimal aligns really nicely with binary, you can perfectly see how much red is in our color. Here we have 6-3 in hexadecimal. And that is why we like to use hexadecimal. It is compact and it aligns really well with binary numbers, making it a great way to view binary data. And that's it. You now know the basics behind hexadecimal. I hope you learned something, and thank you for watching.